myself Dr. G. Suhasini, Assistant Professor of Zoology, Pingil Government College, Warangal, Telangana. Today we are going to discuss about flight adaptations. Birds are the only amniotes with uniquely adapted to aerial mode of life. In birds, flight is the primary mode of locomotion. To escape from predators, to avoid the predator, to obtain better forage, to commute to feeding grounds, to migrate seasonally for breeding, to reach safe place for nesting. Why is flight so important to birds? One of the challenging traits of the birds is the ability to fly with the wings, face strong air resistance, and maintain minimum weight, and change direction during the flight. Obviously, flight is a major evolutionary advantage. Let's see how birds overcome these challenges and fulfill their requirements. Flying birds are heavier than air and shows a number of morphological, anatomical, and physiological modifications to suit their aerial mode of life. These are called volt adaptations. Now coming to our chapter, introduction to flight adaptations, classification of adaptations. There are three types: morphological adaptations, anatomical adaptations, physiological adaptations. What are morphological adaptations? Here we have seven characters. One is body contour, where the body is spindle shaped or streamlined. Exoskeleton, that is body is covered with feathers, different types of feathers like contour feather, quill feather, etc. Organs of flight, the forelimbs are converted into wings, powerful propelling organs propel the body high in air. Equilibrium, maintaining the equilibrium, that is high position of light organs, lungs, air sacs. Low position of heavy muscles, sternum, digestive system, mobile neck and head. Long and flexible mobile neck and the head, birds can easily rotate during its flight and feeding, during the feeding, nesting, etc. Bipedal locomotion. Locomotion is by hind limbs, perching, grip to hold the prey or the branches, tail, it acts as a rudder and steering apparatus. Now coming to body contour. The body of bird is fusiform or spindle shaped to minimize the resistance offered by air during flight. Second one, compact body. Their compact body is light and strong dorsally and heavily ventrally, which help in maintaining equilibrium in the air. The attachment of wings high upon the thorax, the high position of light organs like lungs, air sacs, and low central position of heavy muscles, sternum, and digestive organs below the attachment both the wings, and consequently low center of gravity or other morphological facts of great significance. Now you can see here the streamlined body shape, which reduces air resistance to easy fly, and keen sense of eyesight to spot the prey with a large eyes And here, beak, hook-like beak in case of eagles to tear the prey. And very huge wings, powerful wings to fly and swoop down on prey. Powerful talons to catch hold prey firmly and tear the prey. Here we can see aerofoil shaped wings. See, this is the shape of the wing. Strong chest muscles to generate lift and to reduce air drag. Aerodynamic streamlined body shape and backward arranged feathers. And to reduce weight, no fat deposition is present in birds. Small single organs, thin hollow bones, waterproof feathers. Exoskeleton. Body of all birds is covered by special integumentary derivatives called feathers. Feathers are diagnostic of birds. Since no other group of animals has ever developed them, the smooth, closely fitting and backward directed contour feathers make the body streamlined, helping them to pass through the air by reducing the friction to minimum and much to its buoyancy. The feathers insulate the body perfectly and prevents loss of heat, which enable the bird to endure intense cold at high altitudes and also to maintain constant temperature. You can see here birds which is having rachis, calms and veins. And it is the rachis is having barbs and barbules, hook-like structures interconnected with each other. The small feathers are body contour feathers and these are the down feathers. Here the barbs and barbules, they are arranged in such a manner that they will not allow the water to be absorbed. They are waterproof. Forelimb modified into wings. The forelimbs have transformed into unique and powerful propelling organs, the wings. The wings are solo organs of flight. As we already discussed, the particular shape of the wing with thick, strong leading edge, convex upper surface and concave lower surface cause reduction in air pressure above and increase below with minimum turbulence behind. This helps in driving the bird forward and upward during the flight. Mobile neck and head. The transformation of forelimbs into wings is duly compensated by the presence of beak or bill used for feeding, nest building, preening and offense and defense. The neck is also very long, flexible for the movement of the head necessary for various functions. Perching. The hind limbs of a bird are well specialized for an arboreal life. Their muscles are well developed in such a manner that when bird sits on a branch of a tree, the toes close round the twig automatically. Now you are here, you can see when it sits on the twig automatically, the toes close round the twig. This happens due to so-called perching mechanism. A bird can go to sleep in this position without any fear of falling. Now here you can see the parrot, how the toes are round the twig. Short tail. The short tail of a bird bears a tuft of long tuft of long feathers or rectus, which spread out in a fan-like manner and serve as a rudder during flight. They also assist in steering, lifting, and counterbalancing during flying and perching. Lightness and rigidity of endoskeleton. The skeletal framework of flying birds is very stout and is lightly built on the hollow girder principle. Most of the bones are pneumatic, that is, presence of air cavities. And with the presence of these air cavities, the bone is weightless and provides with secondary plastering to make them rigid. Bone marrow is lacking in bones of the bird. Now here you can see the pneumatic bones, and here this is the wing of the aeroplane. The wings of the birds are also equal to aeroplane wings. Here you can see 7-foot wingspan. Only 4-ounce skeleton in this bird. Adaptations of flight. Honeycombed bones. The cavities that are present in these bones, they are known as honeycombed bones. Anatomical adaptations. Muscular system. This muscular system is very well developed in birds. They are having flight muscles, perching muscles. And in endoskeletal system, skull, vertebral column, girdles, and limbs. Flight muscles. The action of wings is controlled by the flight muscles, which are greatly developed, striated type, weighing about 1/6 of the entire bird. In birds, there are 3 types of muscles. First one, pectoralis major. Second one, pectoralis minor. Third, tensor muscles. Pectoralis major, largest size muscles, when they contract, cause powerful downstroke of wings. Pectoralis minor, when they contract, cause upstroke of the wings. The tensor muscles supplement the pectoralis muscles to elevate the wings. Perching muscles. These muscles in the hind limbs are called perching muscles. There are 2 types of muscles, extensor muscles and flexor muscles. Now here we can see the muscle structure. This is the pectoralis minor inside, and this is the pectoralis major. These 2 are the flight muscles for up and down stroke of the muscles during the flight, which helps during the flight, and which are supported by the tensor muscles. They are coracobranchialis brevis and coracobranchialis longus. And here we can see they are the supporting muscles. And behind these pectoralis major, you have postpatagium, that is the wings, tensor posterius. And here these are supported by the bicep tricep muscles and tensor longus, tensor brevis. And here tendons of the pectoralis major, tendons of the pectoralis minor, you can see here. These muscles support in the lifting of the wings. Endoskeleton. The skull bone are paper-like, thin, and show a tendency towards the reduction in their number. These bones are firmly fused with each other. The posterior portion of the skull is spongy. Teeth are absent in birds. All the thoracic vertebrae except the last are fused into a single massive, giving rigidity to the dorsal part of the vertebral column. fusion of vertebrae provide a firm furculum for the action of wings in striking air. The heterocoeleus vertebrae confer great flexibility, and birds can move their neck through 180 degrees, which help in perching feathers in all parts of the body. The shortening of caudal vertebrae and formation of the pygostyle has assisted stability in air. Now you can see here the endoskeleton, skull, vertebral column, girdles and limbs. Here you can see the skull. It is the very lightweight, and here you can see the beak without any teeth, jaw. Their teeth are absent in case of the birds. And here the cervical vertebrae and the arrangement of the sternum, keel-like sternum. And here you can see the dorsal vertebrae, ilium, and the pygostyle. Here, ischium, pubis, and the ribs, the forelimb, hind limbs. You can see here, they are the perching organs. The toes are, three toes are extending forward and one hind toe is backward. This helps in perching of the, and the forelimbs, they are useful in flight. Physiological adaptations include digestive system, respiratory system, circulatory system, excretory system, reproductive system, nervous system, and thermoregulatory system. Digestive system. The metabolic rate of birds is very high, so the food requirement are great and digestion is rapid. Most birds are very selective in their diet, and accordingly their beaks are variously modified. Further, because undigested waste is minimum and is immediately got rid of, consequently the rectum becomes much reduced in the beak, in the length, and never stores the undigested food. The ill development of rectum of flying birds indicates towards the fact that the flying animals cannot afford to bear the weight of feces. The absence of gallbladder in the birds minimizes the body weight to some extent. Coming to the respiratory system, to meet the extensive rate of metabolism, greater amount of oxygen molecules is needed by the body tissue. For this purpose, the dense, compact and inelastic lungs are supplemented by a remarkable system of air sacs, which grow out from the lungs and occupy all available space between internal organs, even extending to the cavities of hollow bones. The avian lungs are aerated twice at each breath, which secures perfect oxygenation of blood. The air sacs help in regulating body temperature by internal perspiration. Now you can see here the lungs are having the air sacs, which help in the light weight of the body during the flight. Now here you can see the digestive system, esophagus, stomach is not there. Here it is having crop, a sac-like structure, proventriculus and a gizzard, which grinds all the grains whichever the bird eats, and a long intestine, cloaca, and here pancreas and liver. Circulatory system. Avian heart is large, four-chambered heart, and very effective. Due to double circulation in it, the oxygenated and deoxygenated blood remains completely separated. They are warm-blooded or homeothermic animals. Their body temperature remains in between 40 degrees to 46 degrees. The high and constant body temperature enables the bird to take flights at high altitudes and also facilitates activeness in every season. Excretory system. The coprodium of cloaca is another effective water absorbing organ of the birds. For reducing the body weight of no urinary bladder and semi-solid urine. So to reduce the body weight, there is no urinary bladder and semi-solid urine is immediately excreted out and it does not retain in the body. The metabolic nitrogenous wastes are converted into less toxic and insoluble organic compounds such as uric acid and urates, which is an important physiological volant adaptation. Brain and sense organs. The avian brain is highly developed, consists of center, equilibrium, muscular coordination and instinct. The cerebellum is much developed and convoluted, controlling the sense of equilibrium and muscular coordination. The cerebrum is also large and relatively smooth, controlling voluntary movements, behavior, intelligence and memory. Birds have to depend mostly on the sense of sight. So the eyes are large, optic lobes are well developed due to acute vision. Sense of smell is poorly developed, corresponding the ill development of olfactory lobes. Reproductive organs. In female birds, the presence of single ovary on the left side also leads to the reduction of body weight, which is essential for the flight. Thus, it becomes evident that birds are fully developed for terrestrial, arboreal and aerial environment. These adaptations reveals that flight in birds is a technical wonder which enable them to explore new habitats for food and shelter and to escape from the unfavorable climatic conditions and enemies. And answer the following questions. What are the different types of adaptations in birds? What are the flight muscles? Which type of bones are present in birds? Why can't a human fly like birds?